Whenever we see a structure with such wide exhaust stars, it just takes us a look to figure that it's a nuclear power plant. Okay, but have you ever wondered, why do nuclear power plants need such wide, massive exhaust stars? Why don't the regular cylindrical shaped chimneys fit in this scenario? Also, what are they venting into the environment? It isn't radioactive stuff, right? Or is it? In this episode, we'll have an insight into how nuclear power plants work with the help of this massive stars. So guys, without any further ado, let's get on with it. First up, these exhaust stars are known as the cooling towers, and they have this unique shape for a reason. Big power plants like nuclear generate a massive amount of heat to produce power, and they don't always require all the heat generated to function. They need to get rid of this heat to avoid meltdown. So here is how it works. You might have noticed that the power plants are often set up near natural water sources such as rivers, canals, lakes, etc. simply because they need water to cool down the heat generated by the nuclear fission reaction. This is also your answer to why big power plants are generally set up near rivers or canals. Moving on, when the fission reaction happens, it conducts all the heat produced with the water, turning it into steam, which is further routed to several turbines to produce electricity. In the process of running the turbines, the steam eventually loses power and is not potent enough to run the turbines anymore. In this scenario, the steam is now moved to these cooling towers to cool down and get converted into water. When the steam moves into the cooling tower, it is sprayed down from a height and air is blown across the sprayed steam. This converts the steam into water. It is collected in a water basin below the cooling tower and is either reused or released back to the source from where the water was acquired. It's important to get the water to normal temperature before releasing, as hot water is harmful for fish and other forms of life in rivers. So, when the steam cools, condenses, the heat is released as water vapor from the top of the cooling towers into the atmosphere. So you see, it is pure water and does not contain any form of harmful chemicals or radioactive waste. The wide size of the cooling towers provide more surface area for the steam to cool down and let the heat escape from the top. This is the reason why cylindrical chimneys are not good enough for big power plants producing a lot of heat. These massive towers act as a heat sink. The shape is designed to naturally allow water vapor to move out into the environment and the condensed water to settle down. This cooling process is pretty efficient and eco-friendly. It saves and recycles an enormous amount of fresh water, which is something we do not have in abundance. Well guys, this is pretty much it. If you liked the episode, do give it a big thumbs up, share it with your friends. Press the bell icon to be notified of any new content on the channel. This is Curious Planet signing off. Until next time.